You're given this function and you're asked to find the vertical and horizontal asymptotes of the function. So let's think about the vertical asymptote first. What's a vertical asymptote? Vertical asymptotes are places where the function graph goes up, 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 right? Or it could be something that goes down, 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 right? So this will be like an example of a vertical asymptote. Of course, it could be like this. It could also be like both going up, or it could be going both going down, or vice versa. Or it could even be just one side going up. You might have a function where one side goes up, whereas the other side just has a finite value and goes down. Well, that would be a piecewise function. If you have a single fraction, single rational function like this, you would never see anything like that. But what's important is you have to know where these graphs might go to infinity. And if it ever happens, then we know that at those points there's a vertical asymptote. So let's think about this. First, if you look at the denominator, this is x plus 1 times x minus 1. Whereas in the numerator is 6x squared minus 5x minus 1. And then you have a limit as x goes to some place, and I want to see if this is like positive infinity or negative infinity, or the limit doesn't exist or something, right? Now, for all the other values, this is fine, but when x is sent to 1 or negative 1, then the denominator is 0, and you know what can happen if the denominator becomes 0, right? If the denominator does become 0, then the limit could be positive infinity or negative infinity. So after factoring the denominator, it suggests that we have to look into what happens at x going to 1, and also what happens at x goes to negative 1. Let's first think about 1. If you plug in 1 on the top, you get, well, 6 minus 5 minus 1 is 0, right? And if you plug in 1 on the bottom, because of this, 1 minus 1 is 0, so you get 0. So what is this? This is 0 over 0 type limit, right? 0 over 0 type limit. The correct terminology is 0 over 0 type indeterminate. Indeterminate. That's the word. That's the really important word, which means nothing. Which means that this could be something other than does not exist, right? If it was a finite number over zero, then you definitely know that the limit doesn't exist, and immediately you know that it should be a vertical asymptote, right? However, if it's zero over zero type, there's still some possibility, even if the denominator is zero, maybe the entire limit does exist. Now, how would you know that? You would know that by, especially when it's a polynomial, the factor theorem says that when you plug in 1 and you got 0, that means the top also should have x minus 1 as a factor. So if you forgot what this is, there's something called the factor theorem. You might want to look this up. Factor theorem says that if you plug in 1 and you got 0, then it must be that the top thing has this x minus 1 as a factor. So let's see, what should give you this? Well, 6x times x gives you 6x squared, so this must be 6x. And 1 times negative 1 should give you negative 1, so this must be plus 1. And you can check. If you FOIL this out, you'll see that indeed, if you FOIL this out, you get this, okay? And then afterwards, you can cancel this x minus 1s. And then when you plug in 1, you actually get 7 over 2. So that's a finite value. So what does that mean? This means x equals to 1 is not a vertical asymptote. On the other hand, if you plug in negative 1 on the top, you get 6 plus 5 minus 1, so that's 10 on the top. So this thing, you're going to see 10 over 0. That's not an indeterminate. This means that the limit will go to either positive infinity or negative infinity, so the limit does not exist. Now, if you're curious to exactly what's the behavior near negative 1, we can even do a closer analysis, which says limit x going to, let's just do one of them. If I show you how to do one side, you're probably going to be able to do the other side. What's negative 1 minus? What's an example of a number that's slightly less than negative 1? Something like negative 1.001, right? Now those numbers, when you plug it in right here, it's going to be negative, right? So this limit would be 0 minus for this part. And as x gets closer and closer to negative 1, negative 1 minus negative 1 would be negative 2, right? On the other hand, if you plug in negative 1 on the top, you get positive 10. Negative times something that's close to 0 but minus will give you 0 plus. So it's going to be 10 over 0 plus, so that's going to be positive infinity. Which means that if you had the graph, here's negative 1, as you come from the left side, it goes up, 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 right? So that's the behavior. And once you get this infinity or negative infinity, even if it's just one side, we already know that this means x equals to negative 1 is a vertical asymptote. Vertical asymptote. All right, so that's what we figured out. We know that the vertical asymptote is x equal to negative 1. And x equal to 1, although it does make the denominator 0, unfortunately, it is not a vertical asymptote. Okay, so let's write that somewhere there. Vertical asymptote is x equals to negative 1. What about horizontal asymptotes? Well, by horizontal asymptote, I'm talking about the behavior of the function as x goes to positive infinity or negative infinity. So you have to calculate two limits, x goes to positive infinity and limit as x goes to negative infinity. And here we have 6x squared minus 5x minus 1 divided by x squared minus 1, and because of x squared, you can divide top and bottom by x squared, and so you get 6 minus 5 over x minus 1 over x squared, 1 minus 1 over x squared, so that gives you 6, and therefore, what happens is that, I don't know the graph here, but if you go further to the right, say like x is 10, if you plug in x value as 10, you're going to see that the value is very, very close to 6. So at 10, it's very close to the 6. I'm not really sure it would be above 6 or below 6. I think it should be below 6, but that's just my guess, okay? So it's going to get closer and closer to this 6. Okay, so that's why it's called the horizontal asymptote. Now, when you have polynomial over polynomial, you don't have to do this case separately because it always gives you the same value. It will still get 6. So both of these tell us that y equals to 6 is a horizontal asymptote. Now, I didn't explain these asymptotes because you learned it in pre-calculus. So if you are not so sure about what horizontal asymptote means, you should go back and read the pre-calculus textbook to teach yourself what these are. But hopefully it's not a hard concept to grasp. And the answer to this question is that the vertical asymptote is x equal to -1, and the horizontal asymptote is y equal to 6.